In the previous video, we learned about these formation energies, and we learned that they correspond to the enthalpy that it takes to create a molecule from its most stable elemental form, right? So, for example, to create acetylene from its most stable elemental form, it would consume 226.7 kilojoules per mole of heat. Right, this is positive, so it's endothermic, so it actually takes heat to make this molecule from its most stable elemental form, which is carbon solid and hydrogen gas. And in this case, we need two, right? So this is our formation reaction that creates or forms C2H2 from its most stable elemental forms, okay? In this video, we're going to explore why these tables of information are so very useful. All right, so let's go ahead and consider a reaction where we are combusting C2H6. Okay, so we have C2H6, which is a gas, and we know during combustion we always react with oxygen and we always form carbon dioxide and we form water. Okay, if we balance this, we have two here, we're gonna have seven here, we'll have four, and here we have six. Okay, so we can readily calculate the enthalpy of this reaction from this table of standard enthalpies of formation. And the way this works is if you add up the enthalpies of formation of products, and you add up the enthalpy of formation of reactants, and you subtract them, that's gonna be the enthalpy of this reaction. So delta H for the reaction is gonna be the sum of delta H of formation for products minus the delta H of formation for reactants. Okay, so all we have to do is add these values up, go through this process, and we're gonna know the enthalpy of this reaction. All right, so let's go ahead and do it. So on our table here, we can easily find the enthalpy of formation of carbon dioxide gas. And it's important to make note of phase. So we see carbon dioxide gas here. It has an enthalpy of formation of negative 393.5 kilojoules per mole. Okay, and from our balanced reaction, we have four of these. So we have four times this. Okay, and here we have water vapor, okay? It's important to note phase because in our table here, we have two options for water. We have water liquid or we have water vapor. And you note that they're different numbers. So you have to make sure to choose the right phase. And in this case, the enthalpy of formation of water vapor is negative 241.8 kilojoules per mole. And we have six of these, right? So the idea is that these energies are for one molecule. Since we have six waters that are formed, we have to use the formation energy of six of them. Okay, so if we add these up together, this is gonna give us the total enthalpy of formation of our products. So just use your calculator, and you find out that this is negative 3,024.8 kilojoules per mole. So this is the enthalpy of formation of our products from our equation here. We want to do the same thing for our reactants. Okay, so I'll scroll down here. Okay, so, and for our reactants here, we have two C2H6. And from our table, let me choose a color you can see. So from our table, we can find C2H6, that's ethane. It's a gas, so we're in the right phase. We see that our value is negative 84.68. So we have 2 times negative 84.68 kilojoules per mole. Okay, and this was for our C2H6. The value for oxygen, look as hard as you want, and you're not going to find it in this table. And that's because oxygen is already present in its most stable form. So the enthalpy of formation for oxygen is zero. So our O2s are 7 times 0. Okay, if we add these two values up, then we're going to get 2 times negative 84.68, which gives us negative 169.36 kilojoules per mole. And this equals the delta H naught of formation for our reactants. So that's this part of our equation. So just like that, we know our two pieces, and all we have to do is add them up, combine them together to calculate the enthalpy of this reaction. So the standard enthalpy of this reaction is our products here. So it's negative 3024.8 kilojoules per mole minus the energy we found for our reactants, which was negative 169.36. Again, this is kilojoules per mole. And plugging this into your calculator, you're going to find that the enthalpy of this reaction is equal to negative 2,855.44 kilojoules per mole. So this reaction is very exothermic. There's a lot of heat that's produced in this reaction. This is the amount of heat that will be produced, it's produced because of the negative sign, when exactly 1 mole of our reaction occurs. Okay? The really great thing about this approach is that we have these tables of data for the formation enthalpy, which is delta H not F. We also have these tables of data for delta G of formation, so the Gibbs free energy of formation. And in tables, you'll also find what's called S naught. So this is the standard molar entropy, okay? And you can use the standard molar entropy in exactly the same way as we saw for delta H, or you can use for delta G, okay? Instead of using the formation energies, you use these standard molar entropies, and following this equation, you're able to calculate the entropy of a chemical reaction. In the next video, we're going to go ahead and explore entropy in a little bit more detail so that you have a better idea of how you can predict the entropy of a reaction without actually doing calculations.